Hey, Paul, you can take it away.
Well, good morning, everybody, and a very warm welcome to you all. I'm so very glad you've been able to join us this morning for such an important event. My name is Paul O'Byrne, and I'm the Vice President of the Faculty of Health Sciences at McMaster University and the Dean of the Michael G. DeGroote School of Medicine. I would like to start this morning with the very important acknowledgement that McMaster University campus is on the traditional territories of the Mississauga and the Haudenosaunee nations and within the lands protected by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Agreement. I have the very great privilege this morning of being the master of ceremonies for this celebratory event to announce the creation of an important new research chair, as well as its first chair holder. This chair will have a major impact on our extremely important focus on breast cancer research. For most people at this event, the statistics about breast cancer are very well known, and it would be a very rare person at this event, or indeed at any event, who has not been impacted by this terrible disease. According to the Canadian Cancer Society, breast cancer is the most common cancer among Canadian women if you don't include non-melanoma skin cancers, and it is the second leading cause of death from cancer in Canadian women. Today in Canada, there will be 75 Canadian women diagnosed with breast cancer, and today 14 women will die from it in Canada. This shows the desperate need for better research and partnerships to have an impact on these terrible numbers. Towards that improvement, I am very pleased today to announce the creation of the Bright Run Breast Cancer Learning Health Systems Chair. This new and very prestigious position has been created by the organizers of the annual Hamilton Bright Run for Breast Cancer Research and its many, many supporters. They have raised funds for local breast cancer research over the past 14 years, and they've now raised an amazing $2 million to establish this endowed chair. At McMaster, this community involvement is very motivating, and the McMaster president, as well as the Faculty of Health Sciences together, have made a matching commitment of $2 million to set up a chair endowment of $4 million. This is really quite remarkable. I would like to welcome to our event today our speakers who will tell us more about the importance of this development. McMaster's president, Dr. David Farrar, and Hamilton Health Sciences vice president and research and chief innovation officer, Ted Scott. Also, a very special welcome this morning to Dr. Mark Levine, who really has been central to all aspects of this development, both as a professor and former chair of the Department of Oncology for McMaster University, as well as a Bright Run founder. In addition, a very warm welcome to the chair of the tremendously successful Bright Run, Nancy McMillan. I thank you and the whole team of volunteer organizers and all the donors for your generous gift to fast forward our work in this area. I'm also very pleased to welcome our chair of the Department of Oncology, Dr. Jonathan Sussman, and other members of the department and the faculty who have joined us this morning. But it gives me particular pleasure to announce that the first chair holder for this important position is Dr. Ashirbani Saha, who you will hear much more about this morning. I'm so pleased and delighted we have attracted such a remarkably talented scientist who was making such important advances in research earlier in her career. One of the benefits of holding a virtual celebration during the pandemic is that we have had many people join in, not just from here in Hamilton, but across Canada. And I would like to welcome all of those who are attending from organizations and agencies connected to breast cancer research and treatment. Very warm welcome to you all. I would now like to invite McMaster's President and Vice Chancellor, Dr. David Farrar, to virtually welcome you to McMaster.
Thank you, Paul.
As Dr. O'Byrne mentioned, today we're announcing both the creation of the Bright Run Breast Cancer Learning Health Systems Chair and Dr. Ashirbani Saha as the initial chair holder. This event is a tribute to the foresight of the members of the Hamilton community, the organizers, volunteers, and donors to the annual Bright Run for Breast Cancer Research. It was in 2008 that some inspirational breast cancer patients approached the oncology researchers from McMaster and the clinicians, nurses, and therapists of the Jarabinski Cancer Center to consider an opportunity to raise money to fund breast cancer research here in Hamilton. They could see how difficult it was to obtain funding for breast cancer, and they thought that they could both have some fun, but also raise funds for this incredibly important initiative. Have they ever been successful? It's been a lot of work, but in 14 short years, they've raised funds for 16 important local breast cancer research projects. And now they've initiated the 17th project, the creation of this chair. And this chair, as Dr. O'Byrne said, was supported by matching funds from McMaster. I was provost when I first heard of this plan, and I knew how important this research is because I've seen firsthand how devastating breast cancer can be. My mother and my sister both died of breast cancer within 6 months of each other. Supporting research into how to better understand breast cancer is the only way we can stop these tragic events, and this endowed chair will ensure the research needed in this critical area will continue for generations to come. Endowed chairs not only allow us to attract and keep the best people, people like Ashirbani Saha, who is at the cutting edge of using technologies to improve breast cancer and diagnosis and care. These research chairs create a cascading effect to the university through the effect of attracting the brightest researchers, the research dollars, and the best healthcare professional staff and faculty. We know this position, addressing new and better ways for the diagnosis of breast cancer, is as important to everyone involved in the Bright Run as it is to us, and we want to thank you for your commitment to creating and disseminating knowledge for the betterment of our society. And congratulations, Ashirbani. I know this is a proud day for you and for your family, and the university shares in this pride. And thank you, Dr. Mark Levine, Nancy McMillan, and all the volunteers and donors to the Bright Run for your dedication to furthering advancement in this important area. This chair shows the confidence of the Hamilton area citizens in the world-class research of McMaster University. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Farrar. McMaster University has always had wonderful collaborations with our academic hospital partners, and this collaboration is a particular highlight. I would now like to introduce Ted Scott, who's Vice President, Research and Chief Innovation Officer for Hamilton Health Sciences, and ask him to say a few words. Ted.
Thank you so much, Paul, and hello, everyone. I'll echo my thanks to you all for joining us for this exciting announcement today. I'm really thrilled to recognize and thank Dr. Mark Levine and the whole Bright Run team, whose fundraising for local breast cancer research has made such a contribution to the creation of this new chair. In fact, on behalf of Hamilton Health Sciences, I'd also like to thank specifically McMaster University for working so closely with us every step of the way so that we're able to put together these kinds of creative solutions that we know will benefit our patients, our researchers, and our community. But especially, we're very fortunate to have found Dr. Saha, and she's stepping into the role of this inaugural Bright Run Chair. We know that her leadership and expertise in the area of machine learning will help our team improve care for those with breast cancer. At Hamilton Health Sciences, we're focused on transforming the care for our patients, both now and in the future. And because of this work, I can imagine a day when we can provide more accurate breast cancer diagnoses faster, earlier, and less invasively. And I can imagine our patients receiving even more personalized care. So this really is what the promise of research brings for us and how we can imagine better outcomes and longer lives. Now it's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Mark Levine. With a clinical career spanning more than 35 years, Mark saw that for many breast cancer patients, participating in an organized run was part of their healing journey. He believed a local event was important because it would raise funds for breast cancer research right here in Hamilton. And although he has retired from clinical practice, as all on this call will know, Mark remains a very active researcher and a member of the Bright Run Executive Committee. And just to highlight, over the last 14 years, Bright Run has raised more than $4.5 million and supported 17 research projects. Well, this is really just a very, very superficial overview of Mark's contributions, but one that at least will give you some perspective on his amazing work and legacy. So please join me now in welcoming Dr. Mark Levine.
Good morning. What a pleasure to be here. President Farrar, Dean O'Byrne, and Nancy, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you for making this chair happen. I remember I approached Paul in a weak moment. We were flying overseas over the Atlantic. It was in the middle of the night, and I handed him a proposal for the chair. He liked the idea. He then he made a commitment, and then he did the heavy lifting with President Farrar when he was the provost. Nancy didn't take much convincing as head of the executive of the Bright Run. Bright is an acronym for breast cancer research in Greater Hamilton today. It's all about the research. Research improves breast cancer prevention, care, and treatment. Research benefits our patients and their loved ones. In the early years of the Bright experience, we funded what we call operating grants. These funded projects, relatively small projects. For example, they provided some seed funding to help a young investigator begin their research career. They helped generate some preliminary data, which would be useful for a larger grant. As the Bright experience matured, we realized that it was important to do more. The scientists, the people who do the research, are key to building our capacity to do research. This led to the idea and then the reality of the Breast Cancer Learning Health System Chair. As has been said earlier, we are delighted to have recruited Dr. Saha. I'm actually tickled pink that we've recruited her. She's an expert in artificial intelligence. She is going to bring us new ideas, and she's going to help our existing research team reach new goals and successes. In the short time she's been here, she's already accomplished this. Dr. Saha's research will always be leading edge, and it will be patient focused. The establishment of the Bright Run Chair is bold. It's outside of the box thinking. It's visionary. An engineer is being recruited to the Department of Oncology, a clinical department. I am sure that the creation of the chair and the recruitment of Dr. Ashirbani will have an impact for years to come. Thank you. Now, it's my great pleasure to introduce Nancy McMillan. She is the chair of the Bright Run Executive Committee. In 2008, while Nancy was receiving treatment for breast cancer, she was involved in the first first Bright Run event. The following year, she joined the organizing committee, and after that, it's history. In the recent years, she's been the leader of our team. She is a dynamo. She works 24/7 on the event and 365 days of the year. In 2014, she was named a Hamilton Woman of Distinction, and in 2019, she received a Human Touch Award from Cancer Care Ontario for her volunteer work with Bright. Without further ado, my friend Nancy.
Thank you, Dr. Levine. I'm honored to be here representing the Bright Run community. As the event chair, I bring greetings from our participants, our volunteers, our community partners, all of whom have a personal stake in this cutting edge position at McMaster University. The Bright Run is pleased to partner with the university in the establishment of this innovative approach to breast cancer research. For us, it is a very important legacy. It speaks to the heart of what the Bright Run is all about. Over the past 13 years, the Bright Run has funded 16 breast cancer research projects conducted by researchers at McMaster University and the Ashirbani Cancer Center. Some of the projects formed the basis for larger studies funded by national funding organizations. For several years, the Bright Run has been looking for a way to fund something permanent, something that will live on as a testament to the hard work of our participants, volunteers, and community partners. This year, we decided to create a legacy, a position for a bright young researcher who will lead the newest advances in breast cancer research. Congratulations to Dr. Saha, the first scientist to hold this endowed chair, which will continue to support this specific area of research for generations to come. The Bright Run started in 2008 with one purpose: to raise money for local breast cancer research. The event was founded by a group of medical professionals whose patients wanted to give back to the cancer center where so many of us received our life-saving treatment. These medical folks had virtually no experience in organizing a significant event. Most of them had participated in organizing conferences. A few had put together weddings and some big birthday bashes, but nothing on this scale. There were some of the local fundraising community who believed this venture was doomed to fail. It did not. Bright Run remains, as we head towards our 14th event, strong as ever. We run exclusively on volunteer energy. The event pays for itself thanks to community partnerships that include financial and in-kind contributions. Every dollar raised by our participants, every dollar, goes directly to local breast cancer research. The Bright Run's $2 million contribution to the Bright Run chair did not come easily. The sweat equity is enormous. This money was raised by our participants, many of them breast cancer patients and thriver survivors, through sheer hard work and determination. The money was raised $5 and $10 at a time through bake sales, trivia nights, raffles, contests, garage sales, and all kinds of other grassroots fundraising events. For a core group of volunteers, the Bright Run is a year-round commitment. We meet monthly to plan the event. We send out an e-newsletter to our community every month. We're very active on social media, and we're always on the lookout for community partnership opportunities, for fundraising ideas, for new participants and volunteers. Event Day is the culmination of 12 months of effort. It is a coming together of our Bright Run family to celebrate our fundraising success and also to remember. It's an event of energy, electricity, excitement, and yes, a few tears. This year and last, the Bright Run pivoted to a virtual event to ensure the safety of our participants and volunteers during COVID-19. It was a very steep learning curve, but it certainly was worth it. In 2020, we came together virtually for the first time and surpassed our $300,000 fundraising goal at a time when other similar events were canceled or decided to decrease their goals in the face of COVID. 3 days from now, the Bright Run community will be together virtually, and we plan to beat our fundraising goal again. And this year, we will celebrate our partnership in establishing the Bright Run Breast Cancer Learning Health System Research Chair that will make a difference now and far into the future. This is a bright moment indeed, and I thank you. So now, please take a look and listen. Here's a little bit of Bright Run to share with you.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls.
Thank you very much indeed. That was absolutely wonderful. And it looked like everybody was having a lot of fun while generating these really important revenues. Thank you so much, Mark and Nancy, and everybody involved in the Bright Run. Your focus on raising funds with our community to boost breast cancer research in our community is really quite remarkable. I'm now very pleased to introduce the chair of the Department of Oncology for the Michael G. DeGroote School of Medicine. Dr. Jonathan Sussman is a radiation oncologist who is particularly focused on specializing on breast cancer. And Dr. Sussman will introduce the inaugural chairholder. Dr. Sussman.
Thank you very much, Dr. O'Byrne. And thanks to everyone who's attending this incredibly important and special event today. Establishing the Bright Run Breast Cancer Learning Health System Chair is indeed a landmark achievement. This is the first time Brightrun funds are being used to support a researcher directly. The recruitment of an engineer to a clinical department is unique and innovative and has the potential for advancing our research agenda by adding advanced analytic techniques, including machine learning and artificial intelligence, to an already incredibly strong team of researchers. We are indebted to the support and generosity of our community, as Nancy and Mark have so passionately described, and the commitment of the university, as Dr. O'Byrne and President Farrar have described, providing matching funds to make this chair a reality. Breast cancer will affect over 25,000 people this year, mostly women, which translates into approximately 1 in 10 Canadian women being diagnosed during their lifetimes. And Dr. O'Byrne further gave you the statistics that drive us. Advances in screening, diagnosis, treatment, and follow-up care, all informed by high-impact research, and a lot of this led by researchers from right here in Hamilton, have resulted in significant improvement in outcomes, but clearly more work needs to be done. Members of the Department of Oncology are recognized leaders in research that covers the entire breast cancer continuum. After an extensive recruitment process, we are delighted to have Dr. Ashirbani Saha accept our offer to join the Department of Oncology as the inaugural Brightrun Learning Health System Chair. Dr. Saha brings a background in engineering and computer science to our group. We are fortunate to have a data scientist of Dr. Saha's caliber join our team. She will develop her own innovative research program and expand the research capabilities of our current researchers and expert clinicians, as has been described by Dr. Levine and Dr. Scott. In her research, Dr. Saha uses advanced analytics, including machine learning and artificial intelligence, to develop applications for healthcare data. And we'll hear more about that in a few moments. These approaches hold the promise of taking information we already have and helping researchers and clinicians see things in new and innovative ways. Dr. Saha obtained her Bachelor of Engineering in Electronics and Telecommunications Engineering from the Indian Institute of Engineering Science and Technology in Shirpur, India. She then moved to Canada, and in 2010, she completed a Master's of Science in Electrical Engineering, and in 2015, a PhD in Electrical and Computer Engineering from the University of Windsor. After that, she completed postdoctoral fellowship work at Duke University in radiology with a focus on predictive analytics in breast imaging. And most recently, she's completed postdoctoral studies and worked as a research scientist at St. Michael's Hospital in the Department of Neurosurgery, studying predictive analytics in brain imaging as applied to brain injury, as well as having started some work in brain neoplasms as well. In her short career, Dr. Saha has already published over 35 peer-reviewed articles on a broad range of healthcare topics. And in fact, just this past month, she was a senior co-author on a JAMA Network open paper publishing a deep learning algorithm to detect abnormalities on breast tomosynthesis, which is a new and emerging breast imaging modality. We are so excited to have Dr. Saha join our team. So please join me in warmly welcoming our inaugural Brightrun Learning Health System Chair, Dr. Ashirbani Saha.
Thanks, Dr. Sussman, for introducing me. President Farrar, Dean O'Byrne, Nancy, and guests, I'm honored to be the inaugural Brightrun Breast Cancer Learning Health System Chair. It was last summer when I came across the opportunity for this position. I was intrigued by this opportunity because it was different. It was from a clinical department, oncology in this case. The research focus was on breast cancer and artificial intelligence, or AI, together. The phrases breast cancer and artificial intelligence are related to two different academic disciplines, medicine and engineering, which might seem disconnected. However, in the course of history, medicine and engineering joined hands to drive innovations in healthcare. Examples of such technology include MRI and radiation treatment planning systems. The necessity to advance the biomedical sciences has encouraged developments and progress in engineering, computational methods, and technology. These, in turn, have helped medicine to improve healthcare. Therefore, what is new now? Well, the change lies in the speed and the effectiveness at which technology and biomedical science are driving each other now, particularly in the areas where technology development focuses on advanced analytics. The business world often uses the term advanced analytics as an umbrella term for the methods and tools that drive the development and innovation for modeling complex data using AI-based techniques. Today's AI developments are largely based on machine learning that helps training a machine or a computer using relevant information or data such that the trained machine can infer from similar but unseen data later. We have seen phenomenal growth in machine learning-based application in recent times, driven by improvements in machine learning and hardware technology that supports it. Examples of systems that employ advanced analytics or AI in daily lives are smart devices that rely on face recognition or fingerprint recognition to log on, apps like Alexa or Siri that listen to our questions and fetch answers, personalized movie suggestions in Netflix or Prime Video based on our previous choices. Systems like this are getting better day by day, suggesting that at the background, there is a lot of work going on to move from present day's tradition to the next day's innovation. Advanced analytical techniques are increasingly being developed and tested in healthcare worldwide. I will provide a couple of such examples in breast cancer research. AI techniques have demonstrated the potential to assist radiologists in reading screening mammograms and reducing their high workload. Recently, a study from the United Kingdom demonstrated such a system performing at par with the radiologists in the USA. In another effort, scientists from the US gathered relevant information from patient history, imaging reports, and pathological reports to train an AI system to distinguish between high-risk breast lesions that are more likely to benefit from surgery and low-risk lesions that are less likely to upgrade to cancer at surgery. I apologize for being a bit technical now, but I'm happy to provide all of you a taste of the typical roller coaster ride that we data wizards experience in healthcare. It begins by identifying and prioritizing a problem that would benefit from using AI, of course, with the help of experts in the field of healthcare. The next thing is data. Based on your problem, this data can be a part of the wealth of data at the Hamilton Health Sciences, or might be something from a different part of the world, or both. AI is nerdy in nature and stubborn in the way it treats data. So you will need to curate and format the data for the AI to work on it. Your solution might be off-the-shelf usage of existing AI tools or development of novel AI tools. Are you done? No, not without properly testing your system in your laboratory. Are you happy with the performance? No, that's all right. Go back to the design board. What if you're happy? Well, that's great, but the job is not done. Apply the system in practical scenarios. Does it feel like you can improve more with the patients and clinicians' feedback or updates in technology? No worries, we have the learning health system here, which facilitates redesign and improvement in an iterative manner based on feedback. I started in July. The environment that I'm working is nurturing and stimulating for developing AI tools. I'm being mentored by multidisciplinary experts and surrounded by like-minded critical mass of scientists, researchers, technical support members at the Juravinsky Hospital and Cancer Center, Escarpment Cancer Research Institute, the Ontario Clinical Trials Group, and the Center for Data Science and Digital Health at the Hamilton Health Sciences. Since I've been here in Hamilton, I've learned a lot more about the fantastic Bright Run and met some of the executive team members. I have also met some of the supporters of Bright Run during the T-shirt pickup event last month in incognito mode, and learned more about the commitment, energy, effort, and love you put into this event every year to make it successful. I want to thank the Bright Run Executive Committee members and the supporters, participants, and community partners of the Bright Run, the members of the search committee, the Department of Oncology, and McMaster University for providing me with this great opportunity. I want to thank my family, friends, and mentors for being a never-ending source of encouragement, love, and support, all my way to being the inaugural Bright Run Breast Cancer Learning Health System Chair. Thank you.
Well, thank you very much, Ashirbani, for your wonderful words this morning. And I'm back to wrap up this wonderful event. I would like to thank all the speakers and indeed everybody involved in the Bright Run for your commitment and your support, particularly the community support that made the creation of this chair possible. Many congratulations from us all once again, Ashirbani. We're greatly looking forward to celebrating your terrific successes in the future. And finally, thank you all for joining us in this important celebratory event this morning.